VoiceAttack version 2. It's out now and available to download from voiceattack.com, or if you prefer, you can get version 2 from Steam. So is VoiceAttack version 2 an update? No, and that needs to be clear. It is not an update. It's an entirely new product in its own right. Do you have to pay for it? Of course you do. It's a brand new product, a new iteration of VoiceAttack, superseding the decade-old version we've all had free updates for the best part of 10 years. So keep that in mind when it pops into your head about whether or not it's worth it. And for the price of a filthy cheese sandwich and a coffee, well, please. Do you need it? That's entirely up to you. Carry on as you were, so to speak. Just keep using what you've got. However, VoiceAttack version 2 is noticeably faster. It does things. New things. I don't understand it all, but I do know it now has a modernized framework that's optimized with all sorts of improvements. Improvements and support for what's coming next. And that's the new technology on the horizon in this ever-changing gaming world we all dwell in. Installing VoiceAttack version 2. Right, there's a couple of things to consider. Version 2 installs into program files, and not program files 8.6, and in no way updates or upgrades any existing versions of VoiceAttack you may already have. It's a separate installation. For those of you moving from version 1 to version 2, back up your stuff first. Go to where your VoiceAttack V1 installation is, and you'll see both the apps folder and the sounds folder. Select and copy those, and paste them somewhere else in a backup. Once you've done that, you may want to back up some other bits that belong to your profiles, and you'll find those in your user profile under App Data, Roaming and VoiceAttack. Just take the VoiceAttack folder, and once again, just copy and paste that to your backup. Okay, let's go ahead and just install VoiceAttack version 2. During installation, you'll notice that VoiceAttack installs into the Program Files folder, leaving your old version well alone in the Program Files 8.6 folder, so version 2 doesn't get involved in removing anything you already have. Now, once installed, it will have a look to see if you have version 1 sounds and plugins. You'll see this pop up. It'll offer to bring those plugins and your sounds folder contents over to your new version 2 of VoiceAttack. It'll even offer to enable third-party plugins for you. That means all of your existing voice packs will be accessible the moment you launch version 2 of VoiceAttack. Right, you can see my apps folder and the sounds folder in the background here, so we'll head in and see if it's copied everything over correctly. It all seems to be where it should be with both the plugins for third-party apps I have. And now, in the sounds folder, all the voice packs I had are also where they should be. Perfect. Isn't that just fabulous? I can get on with my life now. But one last thing. Let's just check that it has in fact enabled the plugins. Everything looks good, and that wraps up this video. If you get stuck or need a hand with anything, feel free to drop by the HCS VoicePacks Discord, or indeed, VoiceAttack's Discord. There's always someone around to offer support and assistance. Just a heads up, if your issue involves third-party apps like our VoicePacks, you'll be pointed in our direction for help. VoiceAttack's support channels are reserved specifically for the software, so it's always best to pop by and see us at HCS VoicePacks Discord first. Hopefully this helps you make the jump to version 2. You'll definitely notice a big difference. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel. It really does make a huge difference and helps others get the help they need. And if you'd like to see more tutorials, let me know in the comments what you'd like to learn next.